I still aboard Megan's ship? Feels odd.
Interesting. We're back. We woke up aboard the ship, but something feels weird. Well, first off, there's nothing to loot on the ship, so that's definitely an issue. Also, I have two faucets, but no handles. Okay, the door is blocked. Well,
what is this place? Where am I?
I'm pretty sure that wall was there a minute ago. So it looks like we're in the Outsider's Realm. Looks a little bit more dark and dreary than it did last time we were here. Make your way through the void.
I can feel something moving closer. Watching.
Hello, Outsider. You're gonna show up? No? Yeah, there he is. He likes doing it in doorways.
Empress Emily Caldwin. I'm a friend of your father's from the bad old days.
Your voice is much creepier.
I never expected us to meet. I watched your mother die at the hands of schemers who wanted your little empire. Then you were rescued by a killer in a strange mask. I thought that was the end of the excitement. But Delilah and the Duke are flies in the ointment, aren't they? How many of your own subjects are you ready to slaughter? And what are you willing to become?
Whoa, hello, creepy whale.
15 years ago, I asked Corvo that last question. This is the moment that changed him. Now it's your turn, Emily.
So I can accept the Outsider's Mark or reject the offer, no powers mode. No. The powers are awesome, and we are getting them. I need my loot vision.
From the inside, I feel like I'm standing at the edge of something.
Alright. Far reach.
They're true.
Right-click to rapidly pull yourself forward. So, let's see. Towards target surface, primarily a means of locomotion. Far reach is also useful for avoiding enemies. Aim the power at the ground or a structure in front of you to pull yourself rapidly forward, or cast it ledges overhead to pull yourself upward. Far reach can be used to move through glass, breaking it. If the power is used in stealth mode, your movement ends without further forward momentum. The mana cost for using the power is low, so the recharging portion of the mana bar will allow you to far reach even when you have no elixirs. Interesting. Climb up here, secret. Woo! Ow. Come on, game, let me... Nope. Okay, doesn't allow me to let me climb that. I didn't think there'd be much exploration to do in the void. But this is cool.
Incredible.
That is an awesome power. Oh, there's my up arrows.
This is how I'm going to save my father and reclaim the throne.
Such a cool statue, Corvo. Well, I mean, it's him, but I mean... At least he had an awesome pose. No comments on this? Now that looks creepy as shit. Oh, Far Reach is cool. Seems a little bit slower than Blink, but I think it has a lot more vertical potential.
Corvo mentioned
nice.
Being here once.
Gift from the Outsider. Oh, it's Mom's heart. Not creepy in the slightest.
I know you. Do you remember? It's been so long, and you've been through so much. Even as an echo of myself, it's good to know you're there.
Mother? You're here, but you're not here. In my hand, but somewhere else.
Only the last of my essence, with you for a while. If only I could reach across this great expanse and take you into my arms. But I have this to offer. My gift and my curse. Summon me to your hand, and I will guide you when I can.
Well, it's nice that they are completely explicit about that being the old Empress's heart. Equip the heart in your left hand will help you locate bone charms and runes. The heart will begin to beat and glow when you are facing a bone charm or rune, and will beat faster as you get closer. The heart will whisper secrets if you press the right mouse in a particular location or while looking at a person.
There are no stars in the sky here. There is no sky. You shouldn't be here. No one should. In thousands of years, few have seen this place.
It's kind of creepy that I'm actually, like, squeezing it, though.
There's a strange power in this place. I will never walk in the sun again. I know it now. The one who took my life walks the world still. But he has withdrawn.
Ooh, I wonder if that actually keeps the choices we made from the old game in that respect.
A short time ago, I was a girl, then a young woman, in love, then an empress. Now what am I?
Crazy magical heart thing? Alright, so this looks like this is just a dead end.
I remember the last day I saw you, out behind the tower. Lessons from your father, coursing through your head. And lessons from your mother as well. My heart is made of muscle and sinew, but metal and glass as well. And other things.
Okay, cool. So it actually doesn't repeat anymore, which is nice to know when we've actually learned everything about everything.
Who is Delilah, really? How could she? I don't understand.
Can't tell me anything about it? So we have the one-eyed woman. We've got the admiral or some sort. We've got some kind of fancy aristocrat lord. That was the duke. Or is this the duke? I don't remember. We've got whoever the hell this is. And then we have her. Alright. No information. The hell? Triangular backpack. Remember the Illuminati, perhaps? Who knows? Ooh, two runes. Outsider's nice today.
Delilah slit a man's throat for a pair of shoes and painted some of the most brilliant portraits of the age, all in the same year.
Okay.
Survival and ambition, art and magic, with a cunning that makes sycophants of those around her. All of it leading to what you saw at Dunwall Tower. Delilah's playing the long game, and now she's an empress. But I'll let you in on a secret. She's got her eyes set on a much greater prize.
Interesting. Your powers, perhaps? I wonder what that bigger prize is. Thanks for, you know, being mysterious and not telling anybody.
When I was 10 years old, bored with my lessons, I dreamed about sword fighting and sailing the ocean. Now I'm realizing that the world is more off-kilter than I imagined. Everything has been turned inside out. But I'm not gonna stop fighting until it makes sense again. Karnaca's the southernmost port in the Empire. Once proud, but fallen into disarray. Under the new Duke, the Grand Circonan Guard has gotten increasingly oppressive. Beatings and firing squads. The Bloodflies are said to be worse than ever. This is the birthplace of my father. Megan Foster keeps to herself, like she's hiding something. But she helped me escape Dunwall, and for now, I need a place to stay out of sight. Delilah and the Duke made me look like a murderer, using the Crown Killer to butcher my political adversaries. They took what was mine, and I'm gonna get it back, even if I have to burn this city to the ground.
And kill every last guard inside of it. Alright. Ooh, we got some bone charms. Duelist Luck. Void Favor. Goodbye, Kanaka. Musician's Farewell. Letter from Emily. Travel Log. Don't want to grab the crossbow and that stuff just yet. Letter from Emily. Wyman, by now you must have heard that the coup in Dunwall. Don't worry, I'm safe hiding away with friends. I implore you, don't try anything reckless, and don't go back to Gristall. Stay in Morley. There's nothing you can do against Delilah. Can't say that I have a solid plan yet, and you know how well I improvise in desperate situations. But you know how well I improvise. Remember the time I kept a straight face during the watch officer's report, all the while sitting at my desk without pants? If I survive that, I'll get through all this. Okay. Definitely a more interesting empress than I give her credit for. For now, I need to stay hidden and act alone. Trust me. We'll see each other again, I promise, Emily. Travel log. Oops. Day in Dunwall. Started the new year. Maybe 1852 will be less boring than 1851. Can't wait for Wyman to get back to Dunwall. We'll go to the abandoned mansion I discovered the other night at the edge of Rutshar. Maybe I'll have a time to turn it into a scary haunted house beforehand, using sheets and hiding an old audiograph upstairs. Wyman would love that. We'll get spooked and hold hands, screaming and laughing. Come on, Emily. You promised to be more serious and listen at court, and you're already planning your next escape. Let's start this diary again. Proposals for a new decree on whale oil rationing and distribution. And nothing. The anniversary. That time of year again, the anniversary of my mother's death. There's no real time for reflection, though. It's all security protocols, menus, guest lists, and it's impossible to slip out at night. I feel like a caged bird. They've already got me memorizing this year's speech. It's endless. Would it be so terrible if I just said what I remember about her? That wink she gave me, even as she was scolding me after I was caught climbing the statue of my grandfather? The sound of her footsteps as she paced at night? The time we shared a cabin on the boat trip to Driscoll? Or the time she agreed to let Corvo teach me to fish, but then had to pull a hook from my arm? Now that would be a speech. Alright. Edge of the World. Dishonored. My father is lost, turned to stone by Delilah. Those words don't seem real. Witchcraft, something I never would have believed possible. But now I have to believe in it so I can believe that it can be undone. Delilah claims to be my aunt, the rightful heir. Truth or lies? All I know is that she used magic to take my throne, aided by that weasel Duke Abel. They must have been working on their plan for years, buying disloyalty with promises. Even Ramsay, captain of the city watch. Planting in everyone's mind the idea that my father and I could be responsible for those monstrous killings. That one or both of us were the crown killer. I'm not in a trusting mood, but Megan Foster says she knows Anton Sokolov, or old royal physician, and she helped me escape the coup, so she's all I have right now. We're sailing for Cirkenos. My Dunwall, my home, is no longer safe for me. But I was never really safe. I never really will be. The sooner I get that through my skull, the better. The Void. This time it wasn't a dream. I read about the Void and the Outsider, imagined them. Now I've seen these wonders for myself. Strange doesn't begin to cover it. The Outsider has terrible eyes, black on black. He offered me something. I know these gifts come with a price, but how could I refuse? This power might give me the edge I need to defeat Delilah and Duke Abel. I'll worry about paying the cost later. And what price will I pay for his other gift? My mother's beloved voice trapped in the strangest contraption. It's both comforting and chilling to be able to talk to her again. And yet, it's not entirely the person I knew anymore. This thing, this heart, it's there and not there. I have to focus in a new way to even see it. Okay, so no one else sees me wandering around with a heart in my hand. It's just something I can see. That makes sense. We've arrived at the southernmost tip of the Empire. Strange fragrances all around. Salt, fish, spice. I don't know how to blend in here. I don't know what to eat or where to go. Well, we're gonna eat everything, so I mean, you know, that solves that problem. This is where my father was born, so part of me belongs here too. And these are my people, or they were until my throne was stolen by Delilah. Coming for you, Delilah, with my new powers. All I need now is a plan. Oh, we actually have maps. Oh, cool! So now we actually have, whenever we find an area map, we get to keep it. That is actually really, really convenient. I wonder if all of these rooms back here... if I could have gotten into those? I don't know. Maybe that's where my missing coin was in the last area. Alright, meet with Megan Foster, but let's see what powers and bone charms we have. Bone charms first. We can get put five of them on. Alright. And we only own two. Alright, Void Favor. Sometimes supernatural powers consume no mana. Nice. Take that one. Duelist Luck. Bullet packs have a slight chance of containing plus one pistol bullet. Eh, we'll take it for now since we don't have anything better. Alright, powers. Oh wow, we have a lot of it. Alright, so there's powers and enhancements, and then... the hell are these? Oh! Oh wow, okay, so each one of the powers has a tree with branching paths. Holy crap. Okay, so we have our basic strength. Throw objects farther, distract enemies from greater distance with sound of bottle. Unaware enemies can generally be knocked out if hit in the head by thrown objects. But with this upgrade, it's possible even in combat. Ooh, very nice. Greater strength, your overall strength greatly increased, allowing you to shatter weaker wooden doors with your sword. Warning, this is noisy. Okay. Then we have vitality. Your health is increased, allowing you to sustain more damage from attacks. Explosions are falling. With the upgrade, portion of your health bar that regenerates is improved. Regeneration occurs faster. Reflexes. Preternatural abilities allow you to deflect any kind of incoming projectile with your sword by holding... control. Ooh, that's a fancy one. Focus slide. Slow time while sliding if aiming a ranged weapon at an enemy. Well, that's a little specific. Superior deflection. Deflect projectiles towards the nearest enemy. Bullets and bolts that you parry are deflected towards your closest enemy. Ooh, that sounds fun. Adept parry. Window of time for parrying is increased. Time window allows you to parry melee and ranged attacks is increased, allowing you to parry more easily. Yeah, that sounds like one I need to prioritize. Snap reaction. Quick reflexes seem to slow time briefly when an enemy spots you. Quick reflexes seem to plan a quick counterattack or escape without engaging in combat. Interesting. Agility. Increase your jump height and distance. Agility enhancement is a must if you intend to exploit higher ground, making the hidden passageways and special areas easier to reach. This enhancement also offers better mobility for close combat and evasion. Rapid sprint allows you to escape out of sight faster if you're cornered, jump further, or rush to engage enemies. Catfall. Risk higher falls. With this upgrade, you'll take less damage. Bloodthirst. This one might be one we're going to be running on this playthrough. Build up adrenaline combat, then trigger brutal melee fatalities. With this enhancement, your action in combat allows you to build up adrenaline. Assassination, attacking with a sword, parrying, and drop assassination all increase adrenaline. Once you've built up your adrenaline, you can initiate a powerful sword attack that'll kill an enemy with one blow. Build up adrenaline faster. Enables a double adrenaline kill against multiple enemies within range. A well-timed ranged weapon shot can be fired between the two sword swings. Jeez. Bone charm crafting. Craft your own unique bone charms with some chance of corruption. Alright, craft your own bone charms by selecting and combining mystical traits and expanding raw whalebone as a resource. Trait effects are cumulative. If you use a trait more than once, its effect stacks, becoming stronger. Sometimes bone charms will get corrupted during crafting and will also have negative traits. Bone charms with 3 or 4 traits are more likely to be corrupted. Sacrifice bone charms to discover new traits and gain raw whalestone. Ooh, that is cool. So there's a whole crafting and upgrade system in the game. Witchcrafting. Lower chance corruption for bone charms with 3 or 4 traits. Use the same trait up to 4 times across your crafted bone charms. No chance of corruption when crafting bone charms with 3 traits. There's still a low chance of corruption when crafting bone charms with 4. Craft runes by spending raw whalebone or sacrificing existing runes to accumulate raw whalebone for crafting. Ooh. There's a lot of optimization in this one. Holy crap. That is really cool enhancement. Ah, there's Shadow Kill. Turn unaware enemies to ash as they die. Shadow Kill turns unaware enemies to ash upon death. Means I don't have to carry bodies anymore, leaving no corpse behind. Bloodfly Swarm. Transform enemies killed in combat into bloodflies as they die. The upgrades. Enemies killed in combat disintegrate into a cloud of bloodflies that will attack nearby enemies. That sounds like I might hit some of the civilians in the area, but we'll have to see. Whether in combat or unaware... Ooh, okay, so the second upgrade turns everything into ash. The first one only kills the unaware. Nice. That one we might be spending our points on, too, but... Oh, we got our dark vision! See better in darkness. Observe living beings through walls. Pulse securing at regular intervals will show you the directional facing and view cones of your enemies. This enables you to see them through walls, giving you vital situational awareness for a stealthy ambush or for sneaking through the area. So provides visual representations of the sounds you make, further aiding in stealth and helping determine enemy awareness. Greater dark vision. See objects and security systems through walls. Makes it easier to search for resources or missing items, or to deactivate security systems and mechanical enemies. And enemy routes and their intended destinations are now visible to you. Use this info to avoid enemies or to lure them into traps. Ooh, there's so many good things in this power set. But it costs 2 just to get the basic and 3 more to get the loot. But if I get the loot early, I'll have more loot that I can spend on crafting whale charms. So I think what I might do is get this and then go all the way down the whale charm tree. Maybe not getting the decrafting runes. Oh no, I can actually craft runes. By expending a significant amount of raw whale stone. I kind of would rather craft more charms, but maybe I'll have an excess of whalebone later. I don't know how common the resource is. What else can we do with our far reach? So we have the pull objects towards you, catching them, stepping aside, and letting them fly past. Pulled resources will be added to your inventory automatically. Items that can be carried must be grabbed manually. Pull a bottle to you from afar, then throw it as a distraction, or pull a whale oil tank to you and throw it as an explosive. Aiming far reach while falling, time slows, allowing you to move with more precision in a changed direction. Ooh, fancy. Pull enemies. You can pull aim far reach directly on an enemy to pull them violently towards you. You can then assassinate or choke the enemy or move out of the way and watch them slam into the ground or wall. Nice. Domino. Link human targets so they die or fall unconscious together. Domino links 2 human targets. While the power is active, any action taking affects all linked targets. For instance, quickly incapacitate multiple enemies using a single sleep dart, reducing the risk of alarm. Or kill multiple linked enemies simultaneously if outnumbered in a fight. Combine Domino with other powers to create surprising and interesting effects. For instance, summoning a doppelganger and link it to an enemy, any damage you deal to your own doppelganger will be shared by the linked enemy. Ooh, that sounds fun. And the power upgrades link up to 3, and link up to 4. Yeah, that sounds like a tree I'm going to be going down quite a bit. Shadow Walk. Assume a stealthier form for a short time. During Shadow Walk, your visibility is reduced, making it harder for enemies to detect you. Don't get too close, however. A moving shadow will still arouse suspicion. You can assassinate or incapacitate 1 enemy before returning to your physical form. Move through rat tunnels in your stealthier forms. Rat shadows opens up new pathways. Interesting. Improve shadow attack. You can incapacitate 2 people during a shadow walk. Move faster while in your stealthier form. And incapacitate up to 3 people. Wow. Doppelganger. Summon a shade of yourself that attracts enemies. Your doppelganger creates a diversion and flees from enemies, drawing attention away from you. Enemies that destroy your doppelganger will believe they have eliminated any threat in the area and will transition to a less alert state. Your doppelganger will also trigger security systems and attract hostile animals, just as you would. Then we have Duck Gamer's Destroyer disappears, leaves behind a cloud that incapacitates enemies for several seconds. Summon an ally. Let's see, Deadly Shade. Ooh. Summon a doppelganger that can fight enemies and assassinate when undetected. Your doppelganger can engage in combat with enemies or even assassinate them when undetected. It can help you eliminate enemies or distract them while you slip away. Target your own doppelganger and press F to switch places. Transposition. Nice. So we have an escape thing. Summon two doppelgangers of yourself that can deal with more enemies. Shit, we can go into battle with a full army of ourselves. And then Mesmerize. Summon a void spirit to enthrall humans or hounds. Mesmerize creates a void entity that captivates two humans or hounds, then removes their short-term memory. Only those mesmerized can see the summoned entity. Allies of those enthralled will notice their strange behavior and suspect a hostile presence in the area. Mesmerize will always enthrall the closest living target. Use it to avoid a group of enemies who will be unaware of what's happening around them, or use it in combat, enthralling enemies and making them vulnerable to your attacks. Can summon up to, or enthrall up to three, increases duration, and can enthrall up to four. Okay, obviously, we need our dark vision back. So we'll go dark vision, loot vision, and then that will guarantee I don't miss any more runes ever, or any coins or stuff like that. And it'll be really important because that means we'll have the whalebone resources to go and do our whale charm crafting, which I don't think is worth doing a lot of crafting until I get at least to here. So once I get enough that I can get at least three abilities per charm without a disadvantageous charm, we can do that. And I also want the link ability. Like, Domino seems like it's going to be really useful because that means I only have to kill one, and I can kill multiple around me. The other abilities also sound cool and stuff, and I'll probably be putting points into those as well, but I think that is the best path for me right now. So let's grab our dark vision. All right. Okay, let's put dark vision on two, far reach on one, heart will be six like it was last game, let's make grenades nine so I don't accidentally grab them, and bullets will stay at four. Oh, there's rats down in the hold. Oh, so it's like a pulse power this time, rather than a I can always see things? Ooh, that's interesting. It's also a little bit more, like, visually awkward. Circa Noen guitar. Huh. Definitely not a musician. Goodbye, Karnaka, a musician's farewell. Oh, God. Yeah, I'm not gonna read this one. Oh, what the hell, I'll read it. Most pure luck, I managed to get myself passage to Morlaix aboard a decent ship. The Dreadful Whale, it's called. Is that a mistake? Shouldn't it be the Dreadful Whale? Like the sea beast? I didn't want to risk pointing at something like that out to the captain, that Foster lady. She looks like the sort to dump a disagreeable passenger overboard without a second thought. Goodbye, Karnaka, I won't miss you. Times are getting bad there, and I don't want to know what's more unbearable, breathing mind dust all day long, or hearing the constant ramblings of Duke Lucabel over the street speakers. Every bar I played in, some drunk asked me to sing a song, either making the Duke sound like a hero of the people, or the opposite, the worst villain in a generation. Got sick of it pretty fast. It'll take a few weeks to get to Morlaix, give or take some days, depending on the currents and the winds, but I appreciate the company of Captain Foster and the other passenger, a Tivian scholar, I think. Try to help out around the boat as much as I can, cooking, cleaning, and repairing stuff, playing the guitar for them all night. Or at night. I hope they don't throw me to the sharks when they find out I'm dirt broke. I wouldn't be able to pay my fare when we reach Marley. Morlesian food seems to suit Captain Foster. She likes the way I use lots of sugar and toss a shot of whiskey into all my recipes. Even if she groused out at the end of the week for how many of the supplies I'd gone through. Spent the night on the deck with Megan and Anton. Ah, so it was with Sokolov. He was the Tivian scholar. Though he slept in a chair nearby, wrapped in a goat hair blanket that looks like it's been hasn't been washed since it was on the goat's back. I played the guitar while Megan and I drank rum and whiskey, singing sad old Sarconian ballads, and giving silly names to the stars. She even hummed along with me when she got drunk enough, but mostly preferred just to listen. Said I have the same voice as someone she knew once, a long while back. Off and on, I hear her playing the same old audiograph in her cabin, making me wonder if that's who she was talking about. Maybe I'm feeling jealous. Ooh. Gotta go listen to that. What a fool I am, trying to kiss Megan down in the engine room. She didn't even yell, just smiled a sad smile like you would a child who still believes in night spirits. Tomorrow we reach Morley, and I'll disappear as quietly as I can. I've decided to leave her my Sarconian guitar as a souvenir, and the only payment I can afford. I hope she'll forgive me, and that she'll find whoever she's looking for. Aww. I'm betting it's an audio tape from Corvo, but we'll see what we can find out. Aha! Limited resources. It's not what you're used to, living in a palace, but this is all the coin I could scrape up. Anti and I operated on a tight budget, and guess what? Now you do too. If it's not beneath you, pick up whatever valuables you find along your way. You'll need ammo and resources to take down the people behind the coup. Hidden all over the city, there are underground black market shops. Look for a symbol depicting two hands, which means there's a shop nearby. Ooh, thank you for that. Follow the signs, they'll guide you. Buying from the black market is against the law, but it could make the difference against the Duke's military. Sokolov was working on a crossbow as a gift for you. On this crossbow as a gift for you. If you need it modified, those shops can help with that as well. Holy shit. Like a way more powerful version of the old one. Alright, make sure I didn't miss anything in here. Wonder what it looks like when it actually shows me loot and stuff. Oh, it doesn't ping notes again, though. That's kind of annoying. Repair the things that got busted up in Anton's room when he was taken. It's been weeks now. Wait. Maintenance list. Repair the things that got busted up in Anton's room when he was taken. Aw, shit, Anton's been captured? It's been weeks now. No, scratch that. Not until I bring him back home. And as a show of faith that he will be coming back. Unblock the strange door. Looks like something fell on the other side, and I really need to sell the stuff locked up in there to make some coin. Pay the port tax and look the other way fees to those Grand Guard bastards before they wonder who my passenger is this time. I'll do it when I get the money. Interesting. So there's a optional open the cabin. Okay, that's the main room. That's the optional one. Okay, it's really hard to see with dark vision on. I like the old dark vision where we just fade the world color out. Door is locked. Ooh, there's all kinds of goodies in there. Can't do anything with far reach. Sneak in through a window or something? No. What's my mission in the main room? Alright. Unlock the storage room door, find a way to get inside the cabin and open the door. Storage room door is blocked from the inside, find a way to open it. Alright. So I don't want to meet with Megan just yet. So I actually probably could have gotten into that room had I used my power to get like the shadow sneak or something abilities maybe. Oop. Addermeyer solution. Oh, wow, we're at the our city destination. Is this her cabin? Does she have the audiograph that I can listen to? Dreadful whale accounting. Out 32 coins, docking and late fee. Out 25 coins, Piccolo and Tate. Crust removal on hull. New sextant. Gave out coins to mudlarks. Chicken potatoes oil in the market. Anton's seasick pills. Aw, poor Anton, he's seasick. Apothecary on Swain. Matches, length of rope. Night ferry and cargo. Sold rockfish. So, wow, they've only made 6 coins. In like 2 or 3 months? Damn. Out 12 coins, barrel oil, slime removal. Out 20 coins, mutton, carrots, potatoes. Wow. So they are not in good financial shape. Interesting fish. Come on, I wanna hear the audio recording and figure out who it's from. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Dreadful whale sign. Ah,
Dunwall seems so far away. I'll come back soon, Father. I promise.
So there's Tivia, we got Morlaix, so there's Gristle, and then there's the capital of Dunwall. And so we're down in Karnaca at the bottom of Cirkenos. It looks like we came through a river from the earlier cutscene to get here. Very interesting. Interesting. Wonder who that is. Do you have something hidden under your bed, maybe? The little audiograph that I can listen in on and learn how you know my father? No? Damn. Alright, so we need to try and get down into that storage room because it's going to have a whole bunch of shit for us. If we can figure out... Oh! How to get in there. Aha! In through a side port. Someone left a hatch open. Fall in the water. Ah! That was not as hard as I was expecting it to be. Alright, let's see what the dark vision looks like when we actually have items we can pick up. Oh yeah, okay, it's not loot vision yet. That's what it is. I only have people vision. That's right. That's what it is. A lot of copper wire. Enough empty bottles to do whatever the hell I want. Any secrets? Back behind the boxes or anything? No? Empty bed frame. Reflection on my journey to Bandissian Continent 3. Old Patty's Gristle Cider. Is that really it? Just three things of wire? I'm stuck. Oh! Incendiary bolts! Alright, let's get those on the wheel at... Alright, so three... Alright, let's go seven for our bolts. And then incendiary bolts will make eight. We're gonna get a lot of use out of those ones. I wonder if I do that linking thing to people and light one of them on fire, the rest will light on fire. That'd be awesome. Oh, you can actually knock the books around. Reflection on my journey to the Pandissian Continent 3, Anton Sokolov. At dawn, I set out with a group that foraged east and found two other natural philosophers and four crewmen. Oh, and included two others. We used our blaze to clear away the vegetation that grew thickly here and slowly made our way from the shore up a steep incline. Our purpose was to gather samples of the native plants for our research journals. Found myself pressing leaves and stems between pages and talking, taking copious notes on several species of flora I surmised no human had ever set eyes on previously. When suddenly Mr. Gravit from the Academy began hopping about and screaming wildly. Chance had bade him to pick up an unfortunate place to step. Aggressive ant-like creatures swarmed him from below. So many in number were these tiny attackers that we quickly lost sight of him under the onslaught. We finally managed to pull Gravit from the insects, acquiring several painful welts where we had come into contact to come into his aid. Mr. Gravit, however, was bitten, or stung, as I would eventually discover, so many times he was barely recognizable. Swollen into deformity over every inch of his person. Moaning like a sick bull, he expired before we could carry him back to the beach. Luckily, some of the creatures still clung to him, providing me with precious samples. Ah, Sokolov. Such a caring man he always was. Alright, I fixed her door for her. She'll be happy with that. Now, there was some other door or some mess in some other room that Sokolov had left when he was taken.
Must be cursed. Daft old man, this is some shit. Back to that city. What would we have done in the old days? All sharp metal and shadows, we'd say.
Interesting. Oh, there's the engine room. Bathroom.
At least probably not back from Dunwall yet. If we're lucky, the Howlers will be distracted by some score they're working.
So it sounds like Howlers are some kind of gang that we're gonna have to watch out for. Trying to fix secondary engine. Anton, your day of improving the head gasket ceiling with guano coating is the worst you ever had. I'll make you sleep in the engine room if you don't fix this your mess by tomorrow. Megan, if all inventors were as delicate and short-tempered as you and I would probably still be padding around in carved-out logs. Megan, I made some mulberry cake. It's my own recipe, improved by Tivian spices. I left it in the galley. Anton, where are you, old fool? I hope nobody hurt you. I'll find you, I swear. I miss you. Aww. Is this like Anton's girlfriend or something? That's cute. Go, shoe rats. Aw, I thought that was a white rat. Oh, some more crossbow bolts. God, I need my loot vision. No more rats. Sadly, I can no longer eat them to gain more magical power. Yeah, doesn't look like there's anything else hidden down here other than that note. But hey, we learned a little bit more about Anton, Sokolov, and the captain. That's the bathroom. Alright, well, we did everything we could. Let's talk to the captain.
You're up. When you're ready to talk, I'll tell you what I know.
Ugh, that's really bright. That's really- Oh, yes, please. Oh, crystal apple, Morlaix apple, zirconium plantain, some flatbread. Oh, delicious. Oh, my favorite, and my father's favorite, Pratchett jellied eels. Delicious. Some pear soda. What else we got in here? Painting of a tree. Empty glasses. Alright. The Shindari Gift, a study by Amora Clipswitch. On the effects of the winds of the Carnation landmass and resulting economic positions. Whale oil, liquid power. How astonishing that within these beasts, inside oil harvested along with their flesh, was enough power to see the isles through these tumultuous years. And it all seemed limitless, but now the lights begin to dim. Our fisherfolk say the great beasts are increasingly rare. Not all places will suffer this loss equally. Fellow natural philosophers, Carnica has a unique feature, the cleft in Shindari Peak, through which the winds are channeled and amplified. As whale oil begins to run short, with the cost of finding and the remaining leviathans escalating beyond the worth of the oil itself, Karnaka will find itself ascendant among the isles. Interesting.
We've been en route for 2 weeks. I hope Sokolov is all right.
I slept for 2 weeks? Don't have the key to unlock things. What the hell is going on with the camera angle? What is going on? My camera is jiggling. I apologize about that. Sneaky, sneaky? Nope.
Karnaka looks pretty from a distance, but it's a city on the way down. And the blood flies are bad this year.
Playing cards, Blood of the Abel House. Before induction, this episode will focus on Aditha Abel, Steward of Colario. With sword in hand, she swept the marches of raiders, sacrificing her life for Cirkenos. We will provide newly uncovered insights and exploits of Rabinos Abel, who built the ornate wooden bridges of Sagunto. Follow along as we map out the expansions occurred under the Abels, through which trade routes to the other isles were established, bringing riches to the nation's state. Even as waves of settlers continue to join Cirkenos from Morley, the Abels balance growth against Zirconian culture. In later chapters, we will detail the times of Theondis Abel, true son of Cirkenos. Raven but element, he united east and west as no one before him. Even the rowdy people of Bastillion swore loyal to him. One isle, one Cirkenos, united under House Abel. Lastly, we will settle on Luca Abel, who rules today, partaking in feasts and merriments of all kind, bringing joy to our fair isle. Sounds like he's eating all the food that I should be eating. Cannot have that in a competing ruler. Oh, Delilah portrait.
Why is this here? It's Delilah.
Anton started it just before he was taken. They've got history. But he wouldn't.
Interesting. Looks like Anton's workshop over here. Crossbow bolts. Grindstone. So he's working on some gears or something. Interesting. What do we got here? We got some maps. Mortimer Ramsay, inspect.
Ramsay. The Duke couldn't have pulled off the coup without someone inside the City Watch.
We've already eliminated him.
I don't know Duke Luca Abel, but Corvo served under Luca's father and said Theodanus was a good man. Delilah. My aunt, if that's really true.
This is like our
she
kill tracking board.
She has a twisted way of looking at the world. So, the Crown Killer was a tool of the Duke's coup. The murders had a calculated effect. Sokolov seems so much older now.
Looks kind of awesome, though. Why was Sokolov abducted and not killed? Pick yourself, trust those care Atomire solution. Created by Dr. Alexandria Hifada, alchemist renowned at the Atomire Institute of Infectious Disease, derived from rare exotic ingredients, including blood fly venom itself. So it must be blood flies with a new plague kind of thing? Crown Killer had it hiding in Attenmeyer. So what do we got? We got a mansion in the event corridor. There's fisheries. We've got some gates, dockyard, some gardens, a royal conservatory, mining district, up to a peak. So this must be the area where we're going to be starting to explore to begin with.
It looks like the overland route to the Attenmeyer Institute goes through the carriage station.
All right, Megan, let us know what we're doing.
All right, you've explained part of it, but what were you and Sokolov doing here?
The old man loved Karnaka, but he'd caught wind of a conspiracy tied to the Crown Killer. He wanted to warn Corvo.
There are reports about tensions rising, corruption, street violence. I didn't give it much mind. Usually the local authorities resolve that sort of thing.
The new Duke has let things slide. But Sokolov concluded he might be the head of the conspiracy. He came in looking shocked, and if you've heard his after-dinner stories, you know that's unusual. We were going to set out for Dunwall, but something happened.
The Crown Killer.
Yes, the hatch ripped open and Sokolov screamed. All I caught was a glimpse of someone carrying him across the deck. I followed as long as I could, toward Attenmeyer Institute. It's run by the alchemist Hypatia. Maybe the Duke is using a patient of hers, the Crown Killer.
Attenmeyer, all right. I'll get inside. The Crown Killer has to be eliminated, and if the alchemist will cooperate, maybe I can learn something about what happened to Sokolov. Wish me luck.
If you need my luck, Sokolov's as good as dead. When you get done at the Institute, disable the watchtower. Once it's down, I'll bring the boat around. We'll take the skiff to the shore when you're ready.
No one should perish in the mines.
This Dr. Hypatia. She seems to represent the good that's possible within the Empire.
All right, so that seems like we've got our quest lined out for us. I don't know where exactly to go next. Yeah, maybe through this door. Oh, shit. Oh, here's his workshop and more loot. His investigation notes, audiograph. Oh, shit.
Or must I say, your Imperial Majesty, I have something must hear at the first opportunity. It concerns the murders happening across the Empire committed by this so-called Crown Killer. When I left Gristone years ago, I swore I'd never again take part in any further political matters. I've done my share of bad things, and some good.
I'll always miss my lessons with Anton Sokolov. He made so many clever devices during my mother's time.
Conspiracy against you. Here, at the bottom of the Empire, the cobblestones smell of death and corruption. I'm staying with an associate, Megan Foster, aboard her vessel, the Dreadful Whale. We'll leave for Dunwall in the morning, as soon as the tides are willing. I keep thinking of the way sweet Jessamine was stolen from you and your father, and I fear it might be your turn to face such turmoil. I know Corvo would protect you with his life, but please do not trust anyone.
There you are, old man. I was asked to pay you a visit.
Interesting.
What's wrong with you? Megan!
Off we go, Sokolov, to somewhere more private.
So someone who knew, he knew, and it's a female voice, so it could be her? I don't know what it's implying. Kinda wish I hadn't spun the globe in the middle of that. Investigation modes. Why can't an old man enjoy his last years in a warmer climate with good wines and spicy foods without stumbling into another nest of aristocratic vipers eager to coil around the heart of this empire? As I've learned more each week for months now, I found my mind turning over the movements beneath the surface here in Karnaca. Duke Luca Bell and some inner circle seems to have included Captain Mortimer Ramsay of the Dunwall City Watch, a betrayal that boggles the mind. How many others are involved? They aim their venom at our dear Empress Young Emily. That much is certain, but when will they strike and how? Do I dare spend another month gathering stray bits of esoteric information, linking it together with what we already knew? Can we even afford another week? Or should Megan and I set out for Gristall tonight, taking this leaky tub up through the canal? Corvo will not hesitate. He'll act as soon as I hand over what I know. And if I'm too hasty, it might be his undoing, coming home to his native Cirkonos without some critical piece of knowledge about this affair. And then there's the Crown Killer to worry about. If that fiend is part of Duke Abel's schemes, as I suspect, how long until the Dreadful Whale catches the Duke's eye? Apparently, not long. Although that keeps blinking, which is bothering me. I kinda wanna break the glass, but then I'm gonna have to fight whatever's inside there to get that. But I don't know if that's a crafting material I can pick up. Oh, Bloodfly Study. That might tell me if it's useful or not. More on his reflection of the Vendisian continent. Alright, Bloodflies. Let's see what these things are about. Wondered whether I have another book in me. The Bloodfly Academic, coupled with basic information on life cycle and behavior, might make an excellent project for this old natural philosopher. Bloodflies are exotic insects, unlike anything else found in the Cirkonos. I suspect they originate on the Pendician continent. Groups of three or fewer, they are harmless. Individuals won't attack, leading me to speculate that each emits a scent that has a collective effect on a larger number of bloodflies. They're attracted to rapid movement and sound. Their nests can be broken apart, scattering the swarm, and in particular, the nests are quite susceptible to fire. Insects require fresh corpses to lay their eggs, which hatch in breathtaking fashion. After a very short time, more corpses in a Cirkonian city, say, during the crisis or a plague, means more bloodflies. Interestingly, in the last part of a bloodfly's life cycle, they calm a great deal. Leaving the swarm, they molt, causing the wings to drop off. Afterward, each bloodfly lives a solitary existence. Very odd. Bloodflies are largely restricted to the south, preferring warmer climates, like certain aging natural philosophers. So that's definitely more than three. Really curious why that's flashing. Like, it might be a collecting thing. Like, it could be crafting materials or whatnot for making things. Alright, I'm gonna close the door, so that way they don't attack the captain. Quickly read his reflection, and then I'm gonna break the glass and see what I can do. Alright. Anton Sokolov. Color of mine owns a stunning map of the known world, adorned with circules and sea beasts. It is a cherished spot over her mantle. She paid handsomely for it, and was so bristled when I enumerated the various errors. Chief among them, of course, the size and placement of the Pandician continent. Oh, how cartographers are loath to show how small and distant our empire really is compared with that giant landmass. As if Pandicia were but a few days' journey from Iran. Every veteran ship captain knows that it takes months to reach those shores. I had no doubt the Pandicia was rich in resources, but a place must be understood if we ever hope to exploit its myriad treasures. These were my thoughts as I agreed to join this ill-fated expedition. And so it was, on the third day of the month of Earth, under calm gray skies, the great sea vessel and Tia Aquilo set sail with captain, crew, researchers, and myself, 38 of us total, for what would be the most terrifying and spiritually draining experience of my life. I wonder if there's book two somewhere. Alright, let's find out of these blood flies. Oh, wow. Okay, they don't like it when they hear noise. That's very interesting. Alright, where is my flame bolts? Oh. Well, that was significantly simpler than I had expected. Works for me. Dried bloodfly husk. Oh, it was only worth 5 coins, really? Oh, Sokolov's gonna be pissed that I got rid of his little bloodfly nest thing. Thought they'd be more useful for, like, crafting runes and things. Aw. I'm sorry, Sokolov. I owe you bloodflies. On the plus side, I can get rid of Swarm Zone with a single incendiary bolt, which is a good bit of knowledge to learn. That goes back to my cabin. That's the storage room. See what we got on deck.
The Jewel of the South. My father's birthplace.
Empty bottles. Ah! Crossbow bolts and pistol bullets. It's worth coming out on deck to check for things first. Alright, looks like we're setting off on our journey. Get rid of the rats. No, no rats on the ship. Looks like we're setting off for our journey, and next time we'll explore the Sirkonian capital. Ooh, that'll be exciting. Can't wait. Let's see. Telling me if I can leave or you want to stay? I'm not ready yet. We'll do that next time.
It's your show.
So leave a like if you enjoyed, and hopefully we'll be back with another hour-long episode or so of Dishonored 2 tomorrow.